Good morning, students. This is Dr. S. Lal, Professor of Mathematics and Computing and Dean Faculty of Engineering and Technology, Jayoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. In today's class, I am here to teach you calculus and in calculus, today, I will try to explain differential calculus. In your elementary classes of plus 2 level, it has been part of your study that calculus has been divided into two parts. One is differential calculus, another is integral calculus. Differential calculus and integral calculus. So, our matter of discussion for today class is this part, differential calculus. And in differential calculus, first of all, I am teaching you the chapter limit. In this chapter limit, we shall learn a lot at the beginning of differential calculus, and the terms we should firstly define here is what is quantity is what? What do you mean by quantity? Because in so many cases we shall say x is a quantity, y is a quantity, z is a quantity, a is a quantity, b is a quantity, c is a quantity. So firstly, in the beginning of this lecture, you should know that what is the meaning of this term quantity. Quantity is a symbol. It is a symbol. It means a symbol on which both mass operation of bracket, operation of division, operation of multiplication, operation of addition and operation of subtraction may be applied is called a symbol on which whole mass may be applied is a symbol on which whole mass may be applied is said to be a quantity. So this x example, is x, y, a, b, c, 2, 5, 6. These all are quantities because x may be added to x, x may be subtracted to x, x may be multiplied to x, x may be divided to x. We can use this bracket on x. So all mathematical operations are working on x. So x is a quantity. In the like manner, on y, all mathematical operations of bracket, division, multiplication, and addition may be performed. So x is a, and y is also quantity. Similarly, a, b, c, 2, 5, and etc are quantity. Now, see, this quantity has been divided into two parts. One is constant, another is variable. Quantity has been divided into two parts. First is constant and second is variable. Now the question arises that what is constant? Because in so many cases, either that is applied science or that is engineering or whatever may be the subject concerned with you, you have to understand that what is constant and what is variable. So if in a particular mathematical investigation, the value of a quantity doesn't alter, then that is called constant. Means if in a particular investigation, here is variable. So omit the term does not and write the same definition of constant. And omit the term does not from the definition of constant, this will give you the definition of variable. Means if in a particular mathematical investigation, if in a particular mathematical investigation value or values of a quantity alters, then this is said to be example x, y and z. Here I am running three variables in mathematics, x, y and z. In the definition of constant, I have said you already that all 23 letters of English alphabet, all the digits are constant. But in the definition of variable, with confidence we can say that there are only three variables in mathematics, x, y and z. Sometimes we can take constant as a variable, but only on the pressure of supposition, and in that case it is said that that constant which is supposed as variable is said as arbitrary constant. So these x, y, z are variables. Now variable has further been divided into two categories. One is dependent variable, dependent variable. Another is independent variable. Dependent variable and independent variable. Because in limit chapter, in differentiation, in continuity, in differentiability, even in integration, we have to go through the terms dependent variable and independent variable. So in the beginning it will be very difficult for us to understand the definition or meaning of these two terms, dependent variable and independent variable. For that, you see here, I am giving you example, y is equal to x square plus x plus 1. Put x is equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on. So on putting x is equal to 1 here, this is 1 square plus 1 plus 1, 1 square plus 1 plus 1, this is 3. If we put 2, then 2 square, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 2, this is 8. If we put 3, then 3 square plus 3 plus 3, 9 plus 6, 15, and it is 3. We are seeing here that the value of y is depending directly on the value of x. Value of y is depending directly on the value of x. So here x is what? X is independent variable, whereas y is dependent variable. Here x is independent variable and y is dependent variable. In some other cases, you can ask, sir, suppose we are going to put y is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Then this x square plus 2x, x plus x 2x is equal to 1. Here we can find value of x with the help of quadratic equation. If we put here y is equal to 2, then x square plus 2x is equal to 2. This equation will have some many values and this equation will have some values. So here x is dependent variable and y is independent variable. So the nature of a dependent or independent variable depends directly on the mode of operating, or we can say that on the thinking of a student or a scholar, that what value he or she is choosing. So if you are choosing firstly one variable as a fixed value, then the next value you are getting, that will be giving you the value of dependent variable, and the value you have already taken will be considered as independent variable. So now I am going to proceed to our this topic, limit. So see here, all of a function. Form of a function. Now we are coming to this topic, limit. Form of a function. There are two forms of a function. One is determinate. For another is indeterminate. For determinate form, indeterminate form. And in this chapter limit, we shall use this symbol always. Arrow sign. This will be read as tends to means to move towards. If you have to go to Jaipur from this university, then you have to tend towards the roads that is leading to the out from the gate number 1. So this is what? This is tends to. And in limit, this word limit is symbolized with this one LIL or LD or directly LIL. So, what is the meaning of these two terms, determinate and indeterminate? These are the two terms which have given birth of this topic limit. To find limit of a function, a student is asked that find the limit. If a student is asked this question, find the limit. L and L. Limit x tends to 2, x square minus 4 divided by x minus 2. Limit x tends to 2, x square minus 4 divided by x minus 2. If you put direct this value, x is tending to 2, means finally we have to put value of x is equal to 2. So if you put x is equal to 2, then 2 square minus 4 divided by 2 minus 2. So this will give you 4 minus 4 by 2 minus 2, 0. This is 4 minus 4, 0 by 2. Nobody can say what is the value of 0 by 0. In your elementary school, in your high school, in your plus 2 school, your mathematics teacher used to say you that 0 by 0 is equal to 0. This is wrong. Nobody knows what is the value of 0 by 0. It is not always possible to say you. Till today, till this moment I am delivering this lecture in your class of Jayoti Vidyapeeth University. This is not this has not been invented, that what is the value and what is the meaning of the word 0 by 0. So again I am taking this. Example. X tends to 2. I'm taking the same example. X square minus 4 divided by x minus 4. Now see here, limit x tends to 2. Factorize this. X square minus 2 square. This is here x minus 2, not x minus 4, you should say like this, huh? This is x minus 2, so here will be x minus 2, and now limit x tends to 2, this is a square minus b square, that is equal to a plus b and a into a minus b, a plus b into a minus b divided by x minus 2. This will be cancelled. X minus 2 and x minus 2 will be cancelled. Then the result will be x plus 2, x tends to 2, x tends to 2 and x plus 2. Only this will be left. Now put x is equal to 2. Then 2 plus 2, this is equal to 4. Now the question arises, you have taken the same function. Limit x tends to 2, x square minus 4 divided by x minus 2. And the same function is here, limit x tends to 2, x square minus 4 divided by x minus 2. Here you are getting 0 by 0, the final result. And here you are getting 4 as the final result. So, how this happened? This happened due to the mode of operation of the function process. This result 0 by 0 is called indeterminate. We don't know indeterminate. We don't know what is the value of 0 by 0. Whereas this pole is this is determinate, because we can say that 4 is a fixed quantity. So in ordinary sense, if someone asks you that what is limit, then your answer should be to convert an indeterminate form of a function into determinate is the meaning to find the limit of a function. Thank you very much. Thank you.